Among the prominent figures of the suffrage movement in the mid to late 1800s, Matilda Joslyn Gage is less well known than her contemporaries, Susan B. Anthony and Elizabeth Cady Stanton, though that may have more to do with history than her immense influence at the time. For Gage, her support of the abolitionist movement, women's rights, and native rights came from the same place, because she was born with a hatred of oppression. Her family had been part of the Underground Railroad, and she was frequently under surveillance by authorities for her public support of helping fugitive slaves. She was also a vocal proponent of Native American rights and was adopted into the Wolf Clan of the Haudenosaunee Nation. Gage was inspired by her experiences with the Haudenosaunee, on whose traditional lands her home and birthplace of Syracuse, Fayetteville, and Cicero, New York, were built. Among them, she found a society in which women were far more prominent and had a more equal role than in her own. Her first foray into women's rights was speaking at the Women's Rights Convention in Syracuse, New York, in 1852. She was a tireless public speaker, and over her career served as a delegate to both the Republican and Democratic National Conventions, ran a newspaper, The National Citizen, which was dedicated to the topic of women's rights, and authored countless books and articles. Her free-thinking and liberal, sometimes radical attitude put her at odds with the more conservative Susan B. Anthony and the National Women's Suffrage Association. That organization was primarily focused on suffrage, as they felt it would usher in an age of temperance and Christian values. Gage often wrote of Christianity as a tool of patriarchy that she felt contributed to the oppression of women, a position she set forth in her book Woman, Church, and State. This clash with the more conservative branch may be the reason that, despite her immense influence at the time, she is relatively unknown now.